today, quarantine with Maureen, patience. I have no patience for patience. But when I get to sit with this concept of a good teacher of God, I understand that when we are, well, really anytime, but when we are in the midst of a storm or an oncoming storm or in the midst of a huge change, which we are, it would be so much wiser for us to wait and witness than for us to move forward, because delay can provide a new way, and there is great wisdom in waiting. Because these are trying times, and because they are also rich and meaningful times, we're going to have so much more poetry and music and storytelling and creativity come from this hour, because we've taken the time to just be. And, you know, doing those things, singing, dancing, stillness, and storytelling, doing those things don't require that you have an agenda, a plan, you know, a system, a structure. You can just, you know, sing and dance and storytell and be still right where you're at. Those are the four original medicines. When somebody felt detached from their life back in ancient cultures, they would go to the medicine man or woman and they'd say, I don't feel good. And then the questions they would be asked is, when did you stop singing? When did you stop dancing? When did you stop telling your own stories? And when did you stop enjoying the, you know, sweetness of silence? So these are things, these are the things that we should be doing now, not constructing, you know, new scaffolding for plans of the future. Because what I am gathering is that we would be constructing scaffolding on very shaky ground. None of the things that we've known to this point are gonna be carried to the new hour. It's gonna be all new. So we don't want to solve the problem at the level of the problem. We want to come open-minded, open-hearted, open-handed to this new time. And that requires that we let go. And it also requires that we do the little things and let God move the mountains. So do all the little things with great care and let God move the mountains. So we're going to read about patience today. I have MAC lipstick on because I had it in my drawer forever, and I thought, if I don't wear this lipstick now, I might never wear lipstick again. So that's what's going on, folks. Patience. Those who are certain of the outcome can afford to wait and wait without anxiety. Patience is natural to the teacher of God. All he sees is certain outcome at a time perhaps unknown to him as yet, but not in doubt. The time will be as right as is the answer, and this is true for everything that happens now or in the future. The past as well held no mistakes, nothing that did not serve to benefit the world as well as him to whom it seemed to happen. Perhaps it is not understood at this time, even so the teacher of God is willing to reconsider all his past decisions if they are causing pain to anyone. Patience is natural to those who trust, sure of the ultimate interpretation of all things in time. No outcome already seen or yet to come can cause them fear. So those who are certain of the outcome can afford to wait and wait without anxiety. Those who are certain of the outcome can afford to wait and wait without anxiety. That should give you a nice deep breath of peace. Just wait. Just wait. Wait on the flowers to bloom. Wait on the fruit to ripen. Wait on your God to reveal the next right and clear step. And if you get nothing, do nothing. And that's what I say to a lot of my friends and clients when they say, I don't hear anything when I go to God. Great. If you get nothing, do nothing. They're like, well, I don't want to do nothing. Of course you don't. The ego wants to stay busy. But trust me, a little stillness, a little grace period, a little deeper contemplation with your divine is going to be the very thing that that can assist you in your optimal decision making. Patience, patience, patience. I am so impatient with my own patience. I have no patience for patience, but I'm willing, as I know you are. Happy Good Friday. Today we'll also be meeting with Lisa Natoli for Happy Hour at 4 p.m. Central Time. And I also want to invite you to SpeakEasy for our Easter Sunday celebration at 10:30. All of that is on Zoom. And we have an Easter bonnet contest. You might want to wear a little something like this. Hey, Happy Easter. Or a little something like this. Yo, Happy Easter. Or you might want to bring out the big guns and wear something like, what? Feather brain. Come out and enjoy the Easter celebration with us. There will be prizes for the best bonnet. Something really wonderful and magical. Because it's time to celebrate. Christ is risen in all of us. God bless. Namaste.